song. Your hosts for this evening are Angelica and Ken. Sit back and just enjoy.
Hey, Cleveland, how you doing?
What's going on, Cleveland?
Oh, man, you know, we have so much love out there. Angelica, you see all the love that we get everywhere we go. You know, it's just amazing how many people notice who we are out there. You know, Cleveland has a new AM radio show.
That's right. It's 1490 AM Music for Your Ears with Angelica and Kent.
That's right. And you know, they can get in touch with us through Facebook at
Angelica and Kent.
And our Twitter also is
Music F-O-U-R Ears.
You know, we are just so thrilled that the show that we have here, we're going to make a historical live broadcast with my man. You know, you just won't believe who we have here, people. Mr. Ken Hawkins, America's first program director of...
All right! Mr. Hawkins!
Say hello there, Mr. Ken Hawkins.
Hello there, Mr. Ken Hawkins.
You know, it's just amazing, you know, the buzz that we have reaching out here throughout and via our streaming live at
NewsTalkCleveland.com. And you can also get us on the mobile app, TuneIn.com.
WERE. You know, and, you know, my man, we have a little song we'd like to play right now. Maybe it might jolt your memory, Mr. You know, Ken Hawkins of the OJs, and we have coming up. And you remember the song, because I love
music.
Do you remember playing that song, Mr.
Of course I remember.
Oh, yeah.
Everything the OJs played, I played.
All right. And what year was that?
Well, let's see, I started about 54, and then I went to about 77, and then I got away from it.
Wow.
But I was at WJMO most of that. As a matter of fact, all that time.
And
so I left the city.
And for people who aren't aware, can you tell them that you were the first African-American male?
Well, from what I'm told, I was the first African-American general manager of a major radio station.
Yes.
Oh.
And I did that quite well, and we did quite well for the station. And I was very happy about it. My most biggest concern was the fact that I was proud to do it. I was good to Cleveland. Cleveland was good to me.
Well, what an accomplishment. And Kim Sellers, I know, was thanking you, she said, for paving the way for folks like her and Lynn Tolliver.
Yes, she did. And I felt real good just hearing her say that. Yeah, that was good. How much ways I paved, I don't know. I just did my job, and I did what I loved, and I did it the best.
Well,
excuse
Cleveland,
me. I did it the best
you.
I knew how.
Man, you know, you led the nation with your programming, and also catapulted our urban music via through Motown and another record label here that really didn't take off as well as Motown. But we'll get a chance to talk about that. Right now we have the OJs in the background. I Love Music, and we'll be right back.
Good job, Mr. Hawkins. Man, this is a legend right here.
Well,
all you can say is all you need to say.
Yeah. Well, oh, man. It's an honor to be in your presence, sir.
Like radio royalty right here.
Yeah, but I can take pics while I do it. One, two.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Number one. Number
got
one.
It.
That's right.
Got it.
Okay, we got
Angelica.
You got to do one with her.
Good. You ready?
Oh, geez.
Got it.
I'm going around. Some of our spots with the venues where our artists are at.
Okay.
You know, because to keep that going on, you know,
Angelica, it's hard for me to say anything about myself. Because I've been getting my work. I never thought I was going to do this.
Really? Never.
You know, I didn't know that either.
Going like that.
Never thought.
You
know,
the ones that are going begging for attention are the ones that
don't deserve it.
Yeah.
You know, it's amazing how life is when you're doing it at the time. You don't think of it as a big initiative, spearheaded a movement at the time when we needed something, you know, whether we're doing it, also during the time of the Vietnam War.
Yeah. I saw what I thought was a need, and I filled it. I tried to fill it. I started teaching guys how to be radio announcers. They all wanted to know, how do you do that? Well, come on down at the station.
See?
We showed them. At one point, they had to go to Columbia School of Broadcasting. I don't know if you're allowed to say those things, but I'm saying it.
Oh, yeah.
And it costs a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And the people in our day didn't have the money, so we taught them for free.
Okay.
And they did very well. We had a couple of guys here that was pretty good, too.
I don't know what it is about this room.
Stand
by.
I'm standing by. Wait,
friend, let's get ready for what
so
we have to do.
I'm excited to sit.
No, yeah.
We want to get a recap going, Don. Hey, Cleveland, how you doing? You listen to music for your ears with Angelica and
Kent, and it's such an exciting time this evening.
That's right.
The guests we have in here today.
Oh, man, we are broadcasting live every Wednesday from 8 to 9, baby, from the home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Radio 1 Studio, Cleveland, Ohio. This is how we are doing it in 2015, baby. We have a special guest here with me. Mm-hmm. This is a very historical live broadcast today here in our Radio 1 Studios with my man, Ken Hawkins, America's first program director of a major urban radio station, you know, and happened to be in the city of Cleveland, which is the rock capital. So you people know that the rock capital equals Cleveland, and Cleveland equals the rock capital. You know, and Zach Reed, remember this lesson that I taught him also a few shows back away, ain't that right?
That's right. Shout out to you, Zach Reed.
My man, Zach, you know, he was doing it, though. But, you know, we got some recaps that we have to do. Baby, tell me what's going on.
Oh, well, I want to give a shout out to Eric Hamilton we saw at Signs for Tomorrow at Southgate. And then Ron Hartmiller, you know, we saw at Cleveland Botanical Gardens at the Iris Garden.
Yeah, we had a blast there, had lunch there, you know, in the Botanical Gardens. You know, we're just so, Cleveland has so many beautiful things to do here. And we're just trying to enhance that and promote Cleveland in a positive way.
Yes, what an interesting man he is, Ron Hartmiller. He was at Clay's Park when we were there for the 24th Annual Midwest Reggae Fest with Carlos Jones.
With Carlos Jones, that's right. You know, and you can see all that in our Facebook, you know, at Angelica and Kenner. Or you could just Google Angelica and Kent. You'll see all our contact information there.
Yes. And Anne at Whiskey Island, still an eatery. On Friday, we had a nice chat with her. And, you know, we get out so much. And then we introduced Vernon Jones Blues Cartel on Saturday and vocalist Butterscotch. And let's see, there was guitar player Chris Hall, Lovis Watson on bass, Jared Goldweber on harmonica. Oh, is he amazing?
Yes, he was. I tell you, Jared on the Shaker Square, we had a blast. You know, we got a chance to introduce a Vernon Lamar Jones Blues Cartel band there, and man, it was just a wonderful show. People came out and got the chairs, and we rocked the spot from them. We're all glammed up, ready to go. They know we come here to party. Ain't that right, Loretta?
That's right. Also, gonna give a shout out to Elton Smokey Rose, who was on the guitar, and Marianne Goldweber.
Okay, that's it. You know, this was enough of those shout-outs right there. We want to talk about what we've been doing lately.
All right, though.
Okay, you know, and Mr. Ken Hawkins, how are you doing there?
Well, I think I'm doing well.
Really?
I think I'm doing well. I'm happy. I had a good life. You guys in Cleveland helped me to make it. But I just wanted to say something. You know, it's been a long time since I've been into a studio.
Right.
You guys are on fire.
Yeah, Ken and Angelica. Radio man. Music for your ears.
Yes. Compliment from you, Mr. Hawkins. And, you know, in the background, we have another CIA independent artist by Anita Keys, and we'll be back to talk with you a little bit more after that, okay?
Okay, with
this
me.
This is We Make Music.
All right, yeah, that's my man. Okay, now we're going to get into the meat of it. When it got out there, we didn't tack out like a sailboat, but we didn't tack away from shore. Now we're about
to... Hey, what happened to Tolliver? Someone said he was coming
over. Yeah, I don't know where the heck he's at. Where is Tolliver? Can you tell me where is Glenn Tolliver at? Okay, he's supposed to be here. Okay, he know what time he's supposed to be. Where the phone did he...
You know what? It never went through, honey. You know, that's my phone lacking. I hate technology.
What happened?
You need to get Clean Master.
It never went out to him. I was trying to remind him.
Holy smoke. You never told him what time to get here?
Oh, I said, Ken is here at Radio 1. Oh, yeah, we told him.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I see it here. Anytime after 7 p.m. is good. Show's 8 to 9. So.
That's right.
And he got this. I said, Ken is here.
He got those messages. He got those messages.
Yes, this one did go through.
Yeah,
I just checked
it. Let's see, you know. I know he was eager about getting here, you know. And
Man, I've seen Tolliver in a long time.
He's always been up to his words, you know, so... It's been a beautiful
thing. Is he still doing radio here, local?
He's doing online radio.
Oh, okay.
You know?
With Jay King.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay.
He moved over to online radio.
Okay.
You know?
He's a good disc jockey.
Yes.
You know, and we learned from him, I guess, what we did, whatever we're doing, we're mimicking. I don't know what we're doing, Mr. Ken Hawkins, but we're doing
seconds.
It the right way.
20 seconds,
okay?
Alan.
You know, we're getting ready to come back on, baby, with
now
the recap.
We're winging it.
No more shout out. Recap. Hey, Cleveland, this is how we are doing it every Wednesday from 8 to 9 with Angelica and Kent, music for your ears. You ain't never heard AM radio like this before.
No.
Yeah, I hear you playing on the radio.
True.
I hear you playing on the radio.
True.
This is how we're doing it, baby. Cleveland's finest, you know. And we got Mr. Ken Hawkins here, you know.
Yes.
And it's just amazing, you know. And by the way, for those who don't know who Mr. Ken Hawkins is, he was America's first black program director of a radio station in a major city.
That's right.
You know, we have him here right now in our studios. And we're looking for some other people that should be here, you know. But, yeah. But we're going to move on with our recaps right now. What did we do, darling?
Oh, well, Saturday we were at V's Lounge with guitarist Slim and Earl of Pearl.
Oh, man, that's the best daytime blues party. Girl, I'm telling you, you know, people, you got to come out. You know, from 3 to 7 to 8, it's the best daytime party there is. You know, blues with Earl of Pearl and Guitar Slim rocking the spot.
It's a live party there. And we saw Vic Winston, and shout out to Gail Campbell. You know, she was there, and she did a wonderful rendition of At Last by Etta James.
Yes, yes. You know, and just amazing on how much stuff that, you know, Cleveland has prospered. And we're going to be listening to a little bit of music in a second in the background, because I want to talk to my man right here, Ken Hawkins. Now, where did you come up at? Where did you grow up at, Mr. Ken Hawkins?
Well, believe it or not, the first time I spoke at a school, it was over at Woolridge School over on 59th and Kinsman. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they kind of booed me because they thought I was somebody that came down from the hikes and was trying to show them what to do.
Mm.
Then I let them know that, hey, I was born 5 minutes from where you are, 55th and Althway. I didn't come from the hikes. I came from down the street. Okay. What I learned by just doing what I needed to do, where I had to do it, and thank God for what I was able to do. Yes. However, I did believe in three things, and I spoke this a lot at the schools. I said, you find out what you want to be, then you make sure that you love what you want to be.
Right.
And then work like hell to be the best at it.
Oh, that's great advice.
Well, that's what I did, and I think I wound up being the best at something.
Mm-mm.
Yes, you did. It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. Incidentally, Kate and... Kent, I also wound up at WJMO as the general manager of the radio station.
Oh,
before,
man.
Before I left there.
Before you left there, you know, and that was quite an accomplishment.
Yes.
Before, you know, and in the background right now, we have the Ohio Players playing Fire. You remember that song?
All right.
Yeah, well, you know, we're going to get back to you right after we hear a little bit about this, because, you know, my people want to hear this. This is how we're doing it here in Cleveland every Wednesday from 8 to 9, baby, on...
Music for Your Ears.
So can you only on Wednesdays only?
Yeah, we're going out to you. This is fire.
I just got off the phone. I'm doing a photo shoot.
Fire.
Yeah. I'm doing a photo shoot for Mike Calhoun and the Daz Band in the next 72 hours. Hey, Kent.
Yeah.
Daz Band, Mike Calhoun. I'm doing a photo shoot for him in the next 72, and he wants to get back in the studio with you.
Okay.
The Daz. He just told me to let you know the slot. Talk to him, your buddies. He wants to get on, but I'm doing a photo shoot for him this week.
This week? Okay.
I know Friday and Saturday we're doing filming.
Mr. Hawkins knows the Daz Band.
Movie.
He was talking about it in the break room. He used to watch him at the grill.
What was that going on this weekend, Derek?
Friday and Saturday we're doing filming with Maurice, who did 50 Fathers.
Yeah, we're filming for a movie here, a new Cleveland movie. And we don't know what the extent of it. It might be a documentary or a video, but... this is where we've been invited to a lot of things. We just had a meeting early today with Channel 5, and we got one with Channel 3.
Good.
And we're building bridges, people. This is for Cleveland independent artists, and this is how we're doing it right now with my man, Mr. Ken Hawkins, in the Hizzy House, Cleveland, Ohio, all the way from California, coming here to spread some words, you know what I'm saying? The gospel, Cleveland music gospel. All right.
He's on fire.
You guys amaze me.
Nah, you good, Bobby Mr. Hawkins.
Thank you.
We got Bobby Wilson on it.
We got Jackie Wilson's son on the line right now.
Good.
Bobby Wilson. Bobby Brooks Wilson, the one that's not Thor.
Tell him I said hey, and tell Lynn Tolliver to come down here.
Tell him get it out here yesterday.
Yeah.
Now, is he coming on the line live?
Tell him, yes.
Okay.
How you doing?
I'm great. Just fantastic.
The Reddit is a nice commercial for our new business. We changed our name, LNL Photography and Design.
Excellent. Congratulations.
Yep.
Thank you.
That's my better half.
Ready to come in. Which song was his son he did his father? Lady, which one is it? You're always, what is it?
Which song
are
you looking for?
For Jackie Wilson's song they made, Love. What is it? To Be Loved? What? To Be Loved? Which one is
that? This one, To Be Loved, is number 8.
Which one is the song that he made?
Ask him when you're on the line.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, let me get this on over here.
So how's life where you live at now, sir?
Oh, life is wonderful where I live now.
Where you live at now?
I live in the Los Angeles area, California. And I'm loving it. Well, we left here and went to California. And then we moved over into Arizona, and we stayed there a while. And then we went back, thanks to my son, to California again. And
so any celebrities in the neighborhood?
All over. You name them. They're all over where we are.
Oh, yeah. Man, that's great.
Yeah, they're all over. All over. Mm. You know, speaking of Jackie Wilson's, he did my first television show.
Thank you.
Jackie Wilson.
Yeah, and when I celebrated the first anniversary, he came back and did the first anniversary show.
Oh, my goodness. That's great.
All right, we're going to go hot.
You guys ready?
Yeah, ready.
Okay, cool.
Hey, John.
We were going to ask you.
Call us at 216-578-1490. Okay, we're on right now. Jimmy Judy, we got to start about 4 minutes. Right.
Jackie
felt
cool?
No.
Yeah, we got your information, but we wasn't able to print it down.
Several shows in between. Because of the system. But when I had the first anniversary, he came back and did the first show again.
Put it up on the... Okay, that's right. Let's go.
On that email?
All right.
Now?
Hey, Cleveland, how are you doing?
Oh, we're having a great time here tonight.
Oh man, that is the Ohio Players Fire. You remember that back in the day? You remember that back in the day, Mr. Ken Hawkins?
Oh, you know I do. Oh. I played the record over and over and over.
You made it a hit, didn't you?
Yeah.
Oh man, you know, it's just amazing, you know.
I played it, you guys made it a hit. It was already in the thing.
You know, you remember an artist by the name of... Jackie Wilson?
Jackie Wilson did my first television show and then came back for my first anniversary for the second year.
Really?
And did a television show. Of course I remember Jackie Wilson.
Well, you know, that's amazing because, you know, it seemed like Cleveland sort of like basically adopted Jackie Wilson.
Absolutely, yeah.
You know, and with you playing the music. And right now on the line we have Mr. Bobby Brooks Wilson, who is Jackie Wilson's son.
That's what I'm told.
Yeah, and we're going to bring him on right now. Hey, what's happening, Bobby?
How you doing, DJ Kemp?
Oh, man, we are doing fine, man. Angelica, what's happening?
Yeah, Bobby, what's going on?
Just working the world as usual. How you doing, Angelica?
I'm doing wonderful. You know, we got Ken Hawkins in the studio tonight, so it's, a historical time.
Yes, I was listening. That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm doing great, real great, and it's glad to know that we're sharing the same platform.
Yeah.
Back in the day, it was the day.
Yeah, I'm sure it was. I often wish I was back there in those days.
You were there. You were there in spirit.
Man, yeah, this is history.
Isn't this amazing,
but
man?
But it was hard to beat your father, I can tell you that. He could sing and dance.
Yeah, I know. I meet people who he has affected every day. I'm in Hamburg, Germany at the moment.
Okay,
That's right.
Performing a show called Motown the Legend.
Okay,
excellent.
According to them, they are the first Motown show before Berry Gordy did his own version on Broadway. They were first ones because they got permission from the Gordys to use Motown's name and to put together a show.
Wow.
So I was invited out to basically represent my father and open the show with them for the 3-week run they have in Hamburg. This is our opening night.
Tonight's your opening night and you're in Germany, you say?
Yes, sir.
See, this is what I'm talking about. Cleveland, you know, we're worldwide. We are the rock capital, you know, and we have a buzz right here. That's why we're the number one show, right, Bobby? You know,
that's
right. You know, we come from Hamburg, Germany.
I'm just tickled that you, honored that you would call in all the way from Germany. What a blessing.
Hey, I love you guys, and you guys do great work. So why not, you know?
Oh, thank you.
You know, and have you been in touch with Sonny Turner lately?
Yes, I had a show in Las Vegas. I got hired by a this community called Viva Las Vegas. It's a rock village community.
Right.
These are people that come from all over the world to express their versions of rock village music. They hired me because my father had a great deal of that type of music from 1957 to about 1961.
Whoa.
So I do about an hour show of all of his music, walk that walk, talk that talk.
Oh, man.
Around, baby workout.
Right.
I do about an hour of his music. And they really love it because people who've seen him think I do a decent job of him, and people who love him see him in me. So it's kind of cool.
You know.
I've picked up some fans, and I do a lot of work. I do my work on my new CD, and then I do a lot of work on my dad's work. So it's an honor for me to keep his legacy alive.
Well, you know what? I was wondering, so are you going to be bringing that show to the States?
I'm in and out of the States all year round.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, I was just in Las Vegas 2 weeks ago. A place called Anthem. And I played at the Sunshine Casino on fight weekend with your boy Mayweather.
Okay. Yeah, we know the Suncoast, too. Yeah, we were out there. Phil Flowers was out there, too, when we were there.
Yeah.
Two sold-out shows at the Suncoast. Excellent. Name of my show is Jackie Wilson, The Legacy Continues.
Jackie Wilson, The Legacy Continues. What an honor it is to be talking with you this evening. And with Ken Hawkins, I mean, it just doesn't get any better than this, Cleveland.
Okay.
I believe we have some of your... Is that one of your songs playing in the background now, Bobby? Can you hear it?
That's my version. Yes, it is.
Lifting me higher.
Lifting me higher. Well, do you mind if we listen to it for a minute? Are you going to hang on the line? Okay. Let's listen. We got to do it. Reiterate.
That's old Lou calling me in the middle of the show. You're just like
Lou.
Lou Ragland.
Yeah. Lou Ragland.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
They call me in the middle of the doggone show, okay?
Bobby's still hanging on the line, though.
Are you? Okay.
So let's listen to him. Yeah.
This is a song right here, right? Okay, we done fuck.
Yeah, that keeps lifting me.
Where we at on the recap? Where we at on the recap?
Higher and higher.
Okay.
Oh, I love music. I'm not just a photographer, I'm an artist, sir. I love music.
Wake up, moving.
The next one is
next to her.
Another person on hold wanted to speak with Ken, who lives on the same street as him.
That's where we went. What did you say?
Another caller is on hold. He lives on the same street as Ken and wants to talk to him.
That can't be.
I mean, probably.
Hello? Yeah.
Yes,
he is. Okay, Sonny. Okay, I want you to call in. Call this number 216.
Oh, that's it. We had that one on there.
578-1490.
And that's Bobby Wilson with Lifting You Higher. And I believe Mr. Hawkins has something to say to you, Bobby. Are you still on the line?
I'm still on the line.
Bobby, what I want you to do is a big favor for me. When you go back on stage, I want you to do To Be Loved, dedicated to your father from me. Okay?
God is
good.
That's
awesome. I will.
Okay. Don't forget it.
Oh.
He'll understand.
You know, we are making history. You know, that's why we're the number one independent artist radio show, you know?
Now I know.
We are Cleveland's number one. You ain't never heard AM radio like this before.
Not like
AM
this.
AM 1490 WERE, baby. This is how we're doing it every Wednesday from 8 to 9.
Music for your ears with Angelica and Kent.
You know, and you know, Bobby, you know, we talked a little bit about Sonny, you know, and about Lou and stuff, and Ken Hawkins, we only got about 40 seconds left, but would you like to give any shout-outs to anybody and some of your contact information as far as how people like to keep in touch with you and stay in tune with you?
Yeah, I'm very easy to find on the Internet. Just Bobby Wilson or Bobby Brooks Wilson. Just put it in Google, or you can go to my website. I'm on Twitter, Instagram. I'm easy to find if you're looking for me, and I would love to see you at one of my shows. I'd love to come to your city. I'm pretty much I'm pretty busy, and we're working spreading to the Europe this fall. We're going to be doing a radio tour in Europe with my music. So I look forward to seeing you all over the world.
God bless you, Mr. Wilson.
Oh, God bless you, man. Thank you very much for your time. I know you're busy out there in the time. What is the time right now in Germany right now?
Oh, it's 3 a.m. I'm just kicking back. We finished with the show, so I'm just kicking back in my room now.
Ich bin ein super music.
Oh, yeah. We've got the Lemon Pipers coming up now in the background. Green Tambourine. You remember the Lemon Pipers?
Never heard of them.
Okay,
never heard of them.
Listen to this.
Oh, man, this is, you know, Cleveland's finest independent artist. Bobby, you know, it's been nice talking to you. We got to go, but we love you, man.
No problem.
Okay?
Mr. Hawkins.
Yes.
I appreciate the opportunity to meet you over the air.
It's a real, real pleasure, Bobby. And we met many, many, many years ago around Orange, New Jersey. That'll bring back a lot of memories to you.
Well, I wasn't there, but I'm sure.
Okay.
I know my dad was.
Okay.
I wasn't there, no.
Good enough.
But I appreciate you.
When you're in the California area, be sure to let us know because we'll be there to see you.
Yeah, I'm planning on that. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Talk to you soon.
Okay.
All right, Bobby, say hello to Las Vegas. We love you. It's a drive time right now from 5 to 6. Okay?
We love you, Bobby. Blessings.
Love you, too.
All right. Green Tambourine with the Lemon Pipers.
Oh.